Hello all, welcome back to yet another interesting lecture from Easy Dentistry. Today we would be studying about the mummifying agents and the bleaching agents. If you understand our lectures, please do subscribe to our channel. Also share, comment and like our videos. This is a very important lecture for dental students. You should know what are mummifying agents and what are bleaching agents. So watch this lecture carefully. Mummifying agents. What is mummification? Mummification is hardening of dead tissue and rendering it resistant to the microbial attack and degradation. So as Egyptian mummies, it is the mummification is a process of hardening of the dead tissue and rendering it resistant to microbial attack and degradation. So, these mummifying agents are not used in recent days, but the commonly used mummifying agents in the past were first a formulation of formaldehyde or paraformaldehyde with zinc oxide or zinc sulfate plus creosote. All three were combined together to form a paste, and this paste was filled in the root canals. Now, what is the mechanism of action of this paste? Paraformaldehyde release formaldehyde. This formaldehyde destroys the living tissue in the pulp and hardens the pulp tissue, making it resistant to infection. Second mummifying agent which was used is a combination of iodoform and phenol with glycerin. These three ingredients were combined together to form a paste. Eugenol or cinnamon oil was added to this paste to make the smell better. Mechanism of action of this mummifying agent was that the presence of iodine or phenol made the pulp uninfected. Then the third mummifying agent is a combination of tannic acid with certain additives. It is used as a root canal filling material. But the disadvantage of this mummifying agent is systemic toxicity, and in few cases the dead pulp was retained which was prone to infection. Then let's talk about the bleaching agents. Bleaching agents are the agents used to remove stains from the tooth and improve the whiteness of the tooth. Various bleaching agents used are first oxygen releasing agents. These agents they release oxygen, and this oxygen, it reacts with the organic pigment and decolorize and loosen it. Various oxygen releasing agents are hydrogen peroxide, carbamide peroxide, sodium peroxide and sodium perborate. Talking about hydrogen peroxide, it is a primary oxygenating agent. 3% dilution of hydrogen peroxide is used as an antiseptic or anti-plaque agent in a mouthwash, while the higher concentration of 20-30% is used in cosmetic whitening. The 20-30% of hydrogen peroxide plus water is also called as perhydrol or pyrazone. The disadvantages of hydrogen peroxide is the burning sensation, erythema, inflammation of the tissues, and in some cases sloughing of the oral mucosa. Next oxygenating agent is carbamide peroxide in a concentration of 10%. It is nothing but hydrogen peroxide plus urea in equimolar complex. This combination, it releases oxygen when it comes in contact with water. Now, sodium perborate, it is water soluble, and when this comes in contact with water, it releases oxygen which gives a bleaching effect to the tooth. Then is the sodium perborate, which is water insoluble. When it comes in contact with water, it also releases oxygen which gives a bleaching effect. Second type of bleaching agents are the chlorine releasing agents, example of which is a bleaching powder or chlorinated lime. This releases chlorine, which is an oxidizing agent. Addition of acetic acid to the bleaching powder accelerates the reaction, but the disadvantage of using chlorine releasing agent is that excessive use may weaken the tooth and there is disturbance of the oral microbial flora. The third kind of bleaching agent is the reducing agent. Sodium thiosulfate is a reducing agent which is used to remove certain stains such as the stains of iodine. Then a particular kind of method which is used to remove the silver stains from the tooth is the use of an oxidizing agent followed by the use of a reducing agent. This combination removes the silver stains from the tooth. The final bleaching agent we will study here is silica, which is a non-abrasive adsorbent and it absorbs the stains. Recently, lasers are commonly used for whitening of the tooth. So, here we complete with the discussion on mummifying agent and bleaching agents. Thanks for watching the lecture. Do comment and let us know your feedback. Also, share these lectures with all your friends. That's all for now. Happy studying!